Jazz Club.
Your daily grind, everyday nag-work ka, tapos may binubuhay ka mga tao na nakadepende sa'yo, tapos mag-aalat ka a week or a day na wala kang gagawin kung hindi tumadya. There's a certain peace of mind na nabibigay sa'yo eh.
Safety first! Goodbye! Safety first!
Hindi ko nga maintindihan bakit nung may sasakyan ako, hindi ako nakakarating sa mga nararating ko ngayon na pag-bike. Kahit pag-biking mo ako ng 24 hours, walang tigilan eh, kaya. Sa kotse, hindi ko kaya eh. At saka sa bisikleta, you are have freedom.
Ride safe, everybody. Enjoy the experience.
Papagod na tayo sa 40-hour week, right? Compressed into 3 days. That's a challenge. How do you squeeze in your sleep, your nutrition, the time to get stamped in the checkpoints?
Technically, 10% to 20% physical. Pero kung mentally hindi ka prepared sa kanya, most likely kahit malakas, kung nasa isip mo na anytime pwede ako mag-bail out, mag-bail out ka talaga.
This is not a race. No cheating. Enjoy the ride. Enjoy the experience.
Very character building ang ODAX. Kasi walang marshals eh. So you're unsupported. So may mga pwedeng mandaya where if you finish it with integrity, gawin mo ng tama, iba rin yung fulfillment eh.
Okay.
So yung ODAX is a ride. So it came from France. Doon talaga nag-originate. And it means cycling long distances in predetermined time. So, it actually comes from the word audacious. Diba? So, nang matapang ka. Kasi, these rides are unmarshaled and unsupported.
Kumbaga, lalakad ka ng mag-isa, ikaw na rin ang... Ikaw ang magmamanage sa sarili mo. Kung halimbawa, may mga designated control yon. Ang mga sample noon, wala kang madadatnan doon. Ikaw na lang, halimbawa, kunan mo na lang yung karatula ng area na yon na probe na ikaw ay dumaan doon.
Kasi given the nature of the rides, yung distance, it can range from a 200-kilometer ride up to 1,600-kilometer rides. So globally, nangyayari siya. Sa Philippines, merong apat na distances. So we have a 200, a 300, a 400, and a 600-kilometer ride. Tapos lahat yan may predetermined time. Pero in the global scene, marami pang distances under the randonneuring umbrella. So yung ODAX rides are actually qualifying rides for this big, big ride in Paris called Paris-Brest Paris.
Technically, siya yung parang Olympics ng randonneuring. 1,200 kilometers siya from Paris to Brest and then pabalik.
Historically, this is like the oldest, one of the oldest classics in the world. And yung nag-organize, nag-start ng PBP actually is also the same guy who started the Tour de France. And back then, in the early 1900s, the Paris-Brest Paris or PBP used to be a precursor to the Tour de France. A lot of stories and history behind ODAX riding. Because ODAX riding are the qualifiers for Paris-Brest Paris. So if you don't do any of these ODAX rides, you won't be able to participate in PBP, which only happens every 4 years. So how do you qualify? You need to do a 200, a 300, a 400, and a 600 kilometer all in one ODAX season. So all of us, like the organizers in each country, so we organize these rides, all the results from these rides, we submit everything to France. And they're the ones who homologate it, which means they give a certain number. It's a unique number for each result done.
What makes it special for me and what makes it, I think, timeless is that it's a global gathering of cyclists. It's also a festival of all kinds of bikes conquering ultra distances from all over the world. What's also something special about the Paris-Brest Paris is the community. Those who live in the commune serving their croissants, the baguettes, right? The coffee, day and night. And they would be cheering you. One time I was riding, I think it was 2:30 a.m. I was alone, right? But I could hear the voice of a child shouting, "Bon courage!" Pure randonneurie at its finest, right? Right in the middle of those moments where you're questioning, why am I doing this? Why am I at the middle of this climb, right?
When I did my first 400, sabi ko, hindi lang basta ensayo, kahit mag-ensayo ko araw-araw, mahirap to, sabi kong ganun. Wala ka talaga kasing pahinga sa kanya eh. Pagdating mo ng 18 to 20 hours na pumapadyak, kung hindi ka rin nakapag-sleep bank, makakatulog ka na habang pumapadyak eh. Pang nag-autopilot ka na, mararamdaman mo lang medyo tutumba ka, tapos matatauhan ka, padyak ulit, dire-diretso, ganun. Hindi okay. Na physicalan eh. Mararamdaman mo, kaya mo pa, pero inaanto ka na.
I normally divide the route. So, kung 300, I will push it till mag-150. Pagka nakarating na ako ng mga 50, oh my God, sarap nito, pauwi na ako. Pero pagdating ng mga 200 na nito, shucks, pagod na ako. Teka lang ha, kaya ko pa ba? Gaganon ako sa utak ko. Bakit ko ba ito ginagawa? Always ha, always. Oh, tapos yung mga second season to fourth season, sasabihin ko na sa sarili ko, nagawa ko na ito eh. So, ba't kailangan ko pa ulitin? Ganun na yung tanong ko naman. Pero tinatapos ko pa rin naman.
Kasi dyan sa Pilipinas, may sag eh. May escort. Ang ano doon, kasi pag dumayo kayo ng katulad dito sa amin, dito, kung ikukumpara mo dyan sa Pilipinas, mas wala ditong tindahan. Walang tindahan sa mga kalsada. So, wala tindahan ng buko dito. Hindi allowed ang supported. Wala kami sag.
Well, nag-start kami kahit December, before Christmas, sa katindihan ng winter, meron kami 200 kilometers. At yun ang alas 9 ng gabi hanggang alas 10 yata ng umaga. So walang exemption yon kung ang karsada ay nag-IC o kung ano man ang weather. Basta yun eh, nagra-ride kami kahit below zero temperature ang ano.
Coincidentally, I met a few years back in an Odax ride, and he told me that he quit. He needed to stop the ride already, and he's riding with the marshals during that time, right? And he told me, "What happened to your bike? Can it be repaired or something?" You know what he did? He told me, "Look at, try my bike. Try to see if you can ride it at least to the next checkpoint." And I can't believe it, right? Even your own family sometimes, right? Bikes are very personal. But he was there offering it, right? And he told me, "Go finish this. Make it to the next cutoff. Maybe we'll find a way to repair your bike." But I was able to finish because of that guy. I think one of the things that we get from randonneuring and even long distance rides, right? I think this happens, no? Because we are open to the eventualities. We're also open to blessings and goodness in people.
Nung nag-start kami, wala akong balak mag-organize ng Odax sa Philippines. So back then, I was still working for a multinational company, and there would be business trips before that would allow me to go to Singapore. So it was during one of those times that I flew to Singapore for work, and then but I always bring my bike with me. And then I did the Odax here in Singapore, and I really liked it. So I got to talk to a lot of people who were organizing it here in Singapore. And they were asking me, "Carmela, ba't ka ba lipad ng lipad sa Singapore para lang mag-Odax? Ba't hindi mo nalang dalhin yung Odax sa Philippines?" So the first person who told me that was the head of Odax Singapore. And I told him, how could I bring it to the Philippines when, you know, one, if I email the body in Paris, why would they listen to me? Who am I? Anyway, sino ba ako? And then, at the same time, I was like, I haven't organized anything in my life na cycling related before that. So, he said, why don't you check your options and, you know, ask around and maybe, you know, I'll endorse you to the guys in France and to allow you to do some rides in the Philippines. Back then, my head sponsor was David Charlton and he owns the David Salon chain in the country. But he's a very big advocate of women in sports. So sinabi ko sa kanya na parang ayoko ng kumarera. I might not belong to your team anymore because I want to focus on Audax because I really like the format. And then, nagulat ako sa reaction ni David. So, akala ko, papabayaan na niya ako. You know, sige, ayaw mo kumarera. Eh, di, hindi na kita sa sponsoran, di ba? Pero, ang magandang nangyari with David was that he said that Audax is quite big in the UK. In fact, he used to ride some of the Audax rides back in the UK when he was younger. And he said, if you think you can bring the Audax here in the Philippines, if you can get the license from France to run it in the Philippines, I'll support you 100%.
I was expecting before na tipong si Carmelo lang ang magsasalita about long distance cycling kasi siya lang yung may karapatan. Pero now that there are a lot of super randonneurs na marunong pang magsalita, marunong pang mag-communicate and to present and intelligent. Like for example, okay lang ba na mention na like si Attorney Raymond Fortun. Oh, we appreciate the pagkakaroon siya ng Zoom meeting rin to inform people, to inform the newbies what to do during Audax. So those kinds of people na nag-share ng information, it helped the randonneuring grow.
How young? Medyo bata pa, pero mabilis tayo mag-cope up eh ng mga Pilipino, ng mga ganyan. Kasi yung Pilipino sa pag-curious, ang daming way para matutunan.
Dito sa Ireland ha, kasi may ano, pag yung mga Pinoy talaga, parang taga-araw kami, parang mouse kasi bigla na lang susulpo. Kasi lalo na sa mga sportive. Yun. And then, yun nga, nakakilala rin kami. Kasi nga, sumali ako sa endurance. And then, yung uniform namin, laging nakikita. So, sa Audax nga ito ngayon. Kasi sinasabi ko sa mga Pinoy dito, sa Pilipinas, sikat ang Audax.
There's a common language that only ultra-distance cyclists understand, and I think it's that bond of doing this whole challenge together that transcends those language boundaries or even class. It's very deeply moving experience, which, di ba, parang even though parang kalokohan, di ba, 1,200, ba't mo gagawin? Dalawang beses pa akong umulit, di ba? Hindi ka pa ba na ano? So there's something in it that I guess keeps me coming to that experience.
The Philippine Audax community is very unique in such a way. Merong malasakit yung mga tao sa kapwa nila siklista, even if di nila kakilala before the ride. I've seen so many cyclists join the Audax without knowing anybody in the rides, and then after the ride, they're friends with everybody. And every after the Audax rides after that, magkakasama na sila. So the community has really grown in the Philippines because of that kind of attitude. And we've been very inclusive. Yun yung napansin ko eh. Sa lahat ng naging, I mean, it's just like Paris, West Paris, where there's a lot of different cycling machines and everybody does the whole distance in different cycling machines. We are the only cycling event in the Philippines that actually releases a peloton with different cycling machines in one go. And you can see everybody respecting everybody regardless of cycling machine, regardless of background. There's this shared bond amongst long-distance cyclists kasi alam nila na mahirap talaga and the demands are very different.
Kasi until now, I can see some people na willing to try long distance. And I'm willing to help them. Not literally guide them or ano. Pero at least give some advices na, ah, kung gusto mo ng Jariels, ito yung gagawin mo. O kaya, ah, pupunta ka ng Baler, ito dito ka mag-stop. So, it gives me joy na to see other people. So, when you do randonneuring, it's not just for yourself. Do it for yourself first to gain the experience and then share.
Advice ko sa kanila is know yourself and know your gear. Kasi yun yung magdadala sa'yo eh. Sarili mo, yung katawan mo, pag hindi mo kilala, yun yung unang bag down, wala nang silbi kahit na 10 million pa yung bike mo, hindi natatakbo yun. Alam mo kailan kakakain, kailan ka magpapahinga, ano yung pace mo para bumaba yung tatakbuhin mo. So kung target mo ng 3 hours yung specific distance, ano yung average mo lang, kaya mo ba yung average? So kumbaga, dun pa lang sa basic na yun, maano mo na agad kung hanggang saan yung kaya ko.
Yung boss ko, nagsabi sa akin na siya daw sumasakit ng katawan. Kasi hindi, sabi ko, first time mo lang ginawa yan. Pero pag ginawa mo yan araw-araw, parang wala na eh, susunod eh. Wala na, hindi, parang naglalakad ka, di ba? Kung araw-araw, kasi araw-araw mong ginagawa yan. So, wala nang problema yan. Parang normal na sa'yo yan.
Everyone needs to be a beginner. So, all of us have our starting point. If you haven't done your first 10K, then target your first 10K. Right? If you haven't done your first 20K, aim for your first 20K. And as you constantly build upon it, and eventually maybe do your first 100K, then I think that's the spirit of randonneuring, right? It's a personal journey of conquering your personal long distance. What's great about randonneuring is it doesn't care what bike you have or how fast you are. You don't have to be fast. You just need to be fearless and a little bit crazy.